Good Saturday morning. I'm KCRA3 meteorologist Kelly Curran, and while we are expecting relatively quiet conditions across most of the viewing area, we do have a red flag warning for all the areas shaded in red. That does include the Sierra around Lake Tahoe. That starts today at 11 a.m. and continues through 11 p.m. Saturday evening. Winds will be out of the west at about 15 to 25 miles per hour with gusts 30 to 40 miles per hour, and of course that low humidity. That all is a perfect recipe for a heightened fire danger, so be on the lookout. Now, as far as the winds go for the rest of us, yeah, there's certainly going to be a little bit of a breeze today. Stockton about 15 miles per hour at 1 o'clock. You'll see winds gusting up to 25 miles per hour. Same goes for Sacramento, Fairfield, Yuba City, too. The winds, though, will be stronger, trucky in South Lake Tahoe, as we mentioned, 20 to 25 miles per hour. We could see gusts potentially up to 40 miles per hour through the evening hours, and we have a red flag warning because of that. Now, here's a look at future casts. We have a low pressure system that's working its way through. We could potentially see a few showers in far northwestern California today, Mendocino and Humboldt counties possibly. The rest of us all expected to stay dry, but we are going to see that increase of winds from this system and cooler temperatures for the weekend. Now, they bump back up a little bit for the middle of the week, but starting Thursday, another trough of low pressure starts working its way through, and that's going to help knock those temperatures down once again. Here's a look at those 7-day forecasts for the Sierra, expecting a high today around 72 degrees. Again, it will be quite breezy. For the foothills, expecting highs in the low 80s, mid-80s for Sunday. And for Sacramento, today's forecast highs will be in the mid-80s. Again, a little bit of a breeze out there, some gusts 20 to 25 miles per hour out of the southwest. 88 degrees on Sunday, then back into the 90s for Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday before that second low pressure system works its way in, knocking the temperatures back down into the 80s for the end of the week.